Good evening to you, East Texas. I'm Christelle Phillips. Glad you're with us tonight. New details have emerged about a 28-year-old Jasper man who disappeared last Thursday night in Hemp Hill. Authorities are still treating this as a missing persons case, but KTRE obtained federal indictment papers Wednesday night for Alfred Wright, who is charged with embezzlement and theft for allegedly defrauding a Memphis, Tennessee bank back in 2011. East Texas News 9's Michelle Reed has been digging into this case for several days now, and she joins us with new information. Michelle?
Yes, Christelle, I've been putting together this report for several days now, and today I finally started connecting the dots. Now, I spoke to Wright's attorney, Jack Irvine, and he said Wright is accused of committing the crime while he was employed by the Memphis Bank. Jack says that Wright has maintained his innocence and has been very proactive in the defense. He says he actually found out about Wright's disappearance through the internet and is incredibly concerned. It's been a very bizarre story from the beginning. A story of a Christian family man who turns up missing just hours after his car breaks down in Hemp Hill after work.
I have thought of every in and out way that this could have taken place. It's bizarre. My son would never come down that dark road by himself, walking or running.
And it's a story that has left people all over East Texas scratching their heads. According to the indictment papers filed by the Western District of Tennessee, Wright is charged with intending to defraud Independent Bank in Memphis of more than $1,000. So is Wright running from his past?
I can tell you from getting to know Alfred that he's lived an exemplary life. He graduated magna cum laude from college. He's got a physical therapy degree. He's got three wonderful kids and a wonderful wife, and I can tell you that this disappearance, again, I can't imagine that it has anything to do with the allegations up here in Memphis.
Irvine also said that Wright would not agree to a plea bargain even though the penalty was not significant. I reached out to Wright's family about the indictment and was told that they would no longer be doing any more media interviews because their attorney advised them not to. But I was able to confirm that Wright worked for East Texas Home Health in Hemp Hill. Wright's boss, Jolie Ebarb, says she is very concerned for his well-being and hopes things turn out okay. Despite the new allegations against him, Wright's family continues to look for their son and hope that he is okay.
I really feel he is alive. That's my feeling. I just feel he's not dead. I do, you know, and I just hope that I'm right.
Now we still have a lot of questions unanswered, Christelle, and these charges don't explain where Alfred is or even if he is okay. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure that's very unsettling for his family.
Yeah. Michelle, I know that authorities actually called off the ground search. That was actually on Monday night, but are they expected to continue any search efforts for Alfred?
Actually, Christelle, I just got off the phone with Sheriff Tom Maddox, and he told me that they are doing helicopter searches mm-hmm. for Alfred around the clock. Mm-hmm. They are checking buildings and other areas, hoping to find any evidence that he has been there. Maddox says he is not giving up until he finds Alfred.
All right. Thank you so much, Michelle Reed, reporting for us tonight. Thank you so much, Michelle, for that report. Well, in other news tonight, former Nacogdoches...